everyone. It is Saturday, November 17th in the year of our Lord 2012. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. Hell yeah. It's the weekend and it is time to live it up. And we got to start out with our unofficial sponsor of the show. Today's unofficial sponsor of the show is TheRavel.com. That's TheRavel.com. My good friends Johnny and his better half Emma Montgomery. It's Johnny's website. And Emma's just there to support him, and she's just a total sweetheart. He's just an awesome guy. And I work. See, Johnny lives here in Yeehaw, Texas. And so does Emma, and so do I. Yeehaw, Texas, where men and the bulls run scared. That's right. Beer is good for you. So, Emma, what'd you think of that there coffee porter? I know you love these. It's the most favorite beer ever. Awesome. Well, folks, we gotta get to the birthday shout outs, but before I do that, I gotta bust out the beer opening apparatus. Today's beer of the day, the last one I've got from Boulevard Brewing Company. Oh, depressing. Boulevard Pale Ale. Boulevard Brewing Company, Kansas City, Missouri. Or as they like to say, Missouri. Proper beer opening, beer consumption apparatus. That was weak. That was very weak. Minor spillage on my hand. 45 degree angle. Proper pouring technique, as always, right over the keyboard because I'm just that damn good. Boulevard Pale Ale. A good beer indeed, folks. Certainly a good beer. Well, we gotta get to the birthday shout-outs right off the bat. My good man, Scott McVicker. Happy birthday to you, brother. Always great hearing from you. Great family man. And I've known him for 20 years. Almost 20 years. I worked with him in good old California, the land of fruits and nuts. Otherwise known as Western Nevada. And Scott is also an active song pop player like this guy. Although I'm waiting on you there, Scott. Your turn, brother. Like me, he's a fellow Gat God. A genius, a smart man, and Scott, hope you're doing well, hope you enjoy the show, and big cheers and beers to you, party hard and enjoy, party like it's 1969, minus the acid. Ah, next birthday. My man Gilbert, cholera. Now this guy, I hope I pronounced it right, is it cholera, cholera? Let me know. Gilbert, I have yet to meet in person, but we're fellow Facebook app junkies, and he's a great man. Love the Mafia Wars, the Farmville, and all that good stuff. And Gilbert, hope you've had a phenomenal day. Hope you're celebrating well and enjoying it. And I'll celebrate with you. A big cheers and beers to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day, my friend. Ah, next on the list. A spike-chasing badass I work with here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. And my man, Marcus Sullivan. Happy birthday, brother. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're enjoying the day and celebrating it well, partying it up, living it up like good spike chasers you guys always do. And man, it's a pleasure and honor to work with you, brother. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Big cheers and beers to you. And the final birthday of the day. My man, Jason Holden, a.k.a. Habib. Jason, dude, haven't heard from you in a while, man. Love to hear from you. And I've known Jason since 1996, 97. Yeah, I want to say I met you early 97. It might have been late 96 in good old California, the land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon. Well, what's up, my good man? Hope you're doing well. And you know I'm doing well, brother. Always a pleasure hearing from you, you big goofball. Much love to you, brother. No homo. He loves big cars like I do. They don't make them like they used to either. Boy, we know that. But, dude, you have a wicked awesome day, my friend. Party hard and enjoy. And like I say, like I always say, celebrate like it's 1969 minus the acid. All right. Birthday shout-outs are done. We got a couple special shout-outs that I failed to mention a while back. We've got, she was the 100th person to like the Beer and Song of the Day Facebook page. And that would be my friend Michelle Nix. Wicked awesome job. Thank you so much. Thank you to the 220 people who have supported my page thus far. I'm hoping to get to 250 next. That'll be the next milestone. 250,000. Ah, that's right. But thank you so much, Michelle, for your support. Always a pleasure chatting with you. Great lady indeed. I actually met her in Germany.
Yup.
Squeeze me. All right. And how about a 200th like special shout out? Though I have yet to meet this lady in person. Squeeze me. I do know she's a crew dog in good old Germany. Working with my good man, Justin Demmett, who's a sheet metal shaping badass. And we're going to give a shout out to Maegan. Oh boy, I hope I pronounced it right. Moogallion? Moogallion, if Justin spelled it right. Maegan, hey, thank you so much for the support of this here show, and a big special shout out to you. And by the way, she pretty. And so is Michelle. We got pretty fans, folks. That's cool. Lots of lovely ladies that support this here show. It's so nice. The Beer and Song of the Day. And folks, there's a contest out there that y'all need to get involved in right now. I'm going to give a shout out in a moment to the only submission other than my friend Justin Dimmitt for the fan pick of the week. And basically all you got to do, wear a goofy hat, wear a pair of sunglasses, and if you can, a goofy shirt too. That'd be great. Wear that, submit the pick. Be better with a beer in your hand too, by the way. I think that'd make it even better. So, because that's what it's all about, beer and song of the day. So, submit the pick. Tag either Justin or myself in it, or just share it to the Beer and Song of the Day page, and we will make sure that we put it in the fan pick photo album. And folks, I want more support. Okay, how about a shout out to my man Brandon White, who did submit two picks to the Beer and Song of the Day Facebook page, and they're up now in the album. It took me a little to figure it out because I'm technologically retarded, but Brandon is a jetsicle by trade, who I worked with, good old Japan. He fixes engines for a living, and an absolute badass, a great guy, and he submitted two really kick-ass pictures. And Brandon, brother, I give you the salute, man, because you're an awesome guy, a great friend, and it's always a pleasure keeping in touch with you. So a big cheers and beers to you, brother. Hope you enjoy the show, and hope you have a wicked awesome day. And as of now, I think you're winning the contest. Next on the list, how about a shout out to a very good friend of mine that I've known since 1994. My man Jeff Fontaine, living in Springfield, Massachusetts. A Kempo black belt expert badass mofo. A great friend. A fellow T-Tail Mafia 141 badass. Crew dog! And Jeff, much love to you, brother. No homo. Always great chatting with you. Definitely a close friend of mine for many, many years. And one of my biggest buds I've met in my entire life. Jeff, brother. You know what that is. Absolutely. I picked that up from you a long time ago. It's nothing but respect, man. You know? Much respect. But Jeff, dude, a big cheers and beers to you just for being a badass mofo. You have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Celebrate life. That's what I do each and every day. Today ends in a Y. It's a good day. Period. Dot. End of story. That's the way it is. Next on the list. A fellow New England sports fan. A fellow New Englander. And a hottie. And she's awesome. Comical naver. I worked with in good old California, the land of fruits and nuts. She used to work in Japan. I moved to Japan after. And a lot of my friends knew her. A total sweetheart indeed. The lovely Jennifer Moreau. And shout out to you. And thanks for liking the page a while back. Hope you're doing well. Hope you enjoy the show. And I don't know about you, but I am definitely ready for tomorrow. Patriots against the Colts. That's going to be a good one. It's definitely going to be a good one indeed. Nervous. And Jennifer, hey, hope you have a phenomenal day. Just party it up. That's what I'm doing right now. This is an important shout out. He's bored. Bored as can be right now. He's about as excited as two flies doing a dirty deed. That's not very exciting. But he's deep down, he's a great guy. my good man Jordan Tyler.
Hello, Den Star,
because danger is no stranger to an age ranger. And he works here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana. And Jordan Tyler, now this guy, I'll tell you, he's a damn good young man. Born in Massachusetts, lived in Maine, living here in Yeehaw, Texas. And Jordan, you are the witness to the bet that I made with one little J, Jessica Dickinson, over a month ago. Remember that bet? Okay, here's the gig. She's leaving soon, going to a land far away to help preserve freedom and life and find God, good things like that. But Jordan, I need your help, brother. I need you to make sure that she executes her end of the bet when the Colts lose to our Patriots tomorrow. Because I got a bad feeling she's going to accidentally welch out on the bet because she's going to forget about it, get busy, and I don't want to hound her about it because I've hounded her about it already. And she don't even talk to me anymore. Well, she did a little bit, but I know she's been busy. She's been busy as a dyke in a hardware store, to quote the late, great George Carlin. No, I didn't say she's a dyke and busy like that. I did not say that. But also, my man Justin Dimmitt has that same bet going on. I know he'll live up to his end of the bargain when my Patriots beat the Colts tomorrow, because he did that before when the Broncos lost to the Patriots. But, so, I got that bet tomorrow. And tomorrow we're going to give a little shout-out to those folks before I, because that show will be uploaded during the football game. I'm excited about tomorrow's game. Patriots, Colts, 6-3 apiece. Good teams. It's going to be a good game. So, Jordan, make sure that when our Patriots win, that she hooks it up. She is required to wear Patriots gear and take a picture, post it as her profile pic on her Facebook page. And Justin, you know what's up, brother. I'm looking forward to seeing more Patriots stuff on your page again. That's right. Because the Patriots are not going to lose. And if they do, I'll be wearing Colts stuff on my Facebook page for a 24-hour period. A little nervous, I will admit. But not that nervous. Now here, one more shout-out. And here's to a great man, though he is a Yankees fan. He's a damn good man. Comical nab, badass, who I worked with in good old Japan. Probably knows my good friend Jennifer Moreau. I'm sure he does. How about the man, Izzy Reyes? Dude, just give me a shout-out. Just want to say thanks for your support of my show. Thanks for all. It's always a pleasure chatting with you, man. It really is. We're wicked, hardcore, passionate sports fans. And you've been a Yankees fan probably longer than I've been a Red Sox fan because you're older than me. So I give you credit. I always give credit to those Yankee fans that actually know the team. And Izzy, you're definitely one of them, brother. And if I remember correctly, you're a Giants fan too. Hey, nothing wrong with supporting the home, because that's what I do. Much respect to all you teams that support your home team. Jordan does. Jessica does. Brandon, I believe you do. My man Jason Holden, I don't think, cares about sports. I know Jennifer Moreau, she's definitely a homer. We're proud to be homers. Justin Dimmitt's a homer. He's an Indianapolis type of guy. So, much respect to all you home fans. All right, I've rambled on a little bit. Time to get to celebrity birthdays. Two legends born in 1944, and that would be one Danny DeVito and former Mets pitcher, badass Tom Seaver. Both born November 17th, 1944. 52 years ago today, RuPaul. Remember RuPaul, the cross-dressing dude? Two hotties were born in 1966 on this day. Daisy Fuentes. Latin supermodel, and once hosted America's Funniest Home Videos. She's gorgeous. She's 46 today. And how about Sophie Marceau, French actress who's been naked for a long time in movies, and she was the hot chick in Braveheart. Yeah, she's freaking smoking hot, folks. She is smoking hot. 69 years ago today, Lauren Hutton was born. She's an actress and former model as well. Ah, here's a badass director. He's 70 years old today. How about Martin Scorsese? That's right. Casino, Goodfellas. Dude's an incredible, incredible director. On his day in 1938, singer Gordon Lightfoot was born, a definite badass. How about the guy that made AIDS famous? An incredible actor indeed. I cannot believe he was gay because he was a bay magnet. The late, great Rock Hudson, born in 1925 on this day, passed away in 1985 from AIDS. I remember when he revealed he had AIDS, it was the first famous person to mention that they had AIDS. And AIDS was then known as the gay disease. Well, we found out later that it wasn't just for gays, because there were plenty of heterosexual people that caught AIDS as well. On his day in 1983, Ryan Braun, Milwaukee Brewers badass baseball player, was born. And finally, on this day in 1978, and I know my man Justin Dimmitt will appreciate this, Little J, she'll appreciate it as well, Reggie Wayne, wide receiver, Indianapolis Colts. He's 34 today. Now, Jessica, I wonder if she even knows the lineup of the Indianapolis Colts. I'm calling her out, Jordan. You let her know I'm calling her ass out. Because if she's a true fan, she doesn't talk about football very much. Methinks me has me doubts. I don't know. Just saying. Wow, I'm being a dick today. Oh, I'm just busting her chops. It's all out of fun. Getting prepared. Talking the trash before the game. That's what I'm doing. On this day in 1749, he passed away in 1841 at the age of 92 years old. That'd be one Nicholas Appert, who was the father of canning. Canned food for food preservation. That's the guy. Probably why he lived to be so long, which that's a long life to live back in those days. Average life expectancy was probably about 50, 60 years old tops. All right, with that said, here's some historical facts of the day. On the day 1928, the great famous Boston Garden opened. Yes, the original badass one. Boy, I missed that place. How about this one? On this day in 1913, the Panama Canal opened. Wow. Ironically, on this day in 1869, the Suez Canal opened, connecting the Mediterranean and Red Seas. Yes, the two most famous canals in the world both opened. All right, the Erie Canal is pretty famous. I don't know when that one opened, though. We'll find out eventually. Oh, almost forgot a belated birthday shout-out to my man Justin Dimmitt's mom, Gail Riggs. Yesterday was her birthday, November 16th. So, Gail, if you're watching this show, a huge shout-out to you. Happy birthday, Gail. Hope you did have a wicked awesome day. Hope you celebrated well and enjoyed. Hope you enjoyed with an adult beverage, preferably beer. And Justin, your son is an amazing, amazing young man. A very good friend of mine. Love the guy. No, not in that way. But Gail, hope you enjoy the show and hope you love to hear from you. You can chime into the Beer and Song of the Day Facebook page or Strangers, a friend you haven't met. Remember that? Because I'm all about that, so. Alrighty. On this day in 1991, the first condom ad on TV in the U.S. appeared. Fox Television. 20 years ago today, the North American Free Trade Agreement, otherwise known as NAFTA, was approved by the House of Representatives. On this day in 1968, some of you older folks out there will remember this. People still talk about it 44 years later. The infamous Heidi game. Sunday night football game. Now, the movie Heidi was slated to come on at, I can't remember if it was 7 p.m. or 8 p.m. But the movie came on despite the fact that there was still a football game going on between the Raiders and the Jets. Oakland Raiders and New York Jets. Now, they went to the movie Heidi. People started calling NBC TV station, okay? And people were pissed. The Raiders, once they came back to the football game, the Raiders had rallied to beat the Jets 43-32. And people were like, WTF, mate. So because of that incident, now you know why football games will go. All live sporting events will air until it's over before scheduled programming comes into effect. When scheduled programs are out there, they will be halted until the sports events complete. Case in point, ESPN aired the World Series of Poker. And that last round between three people, including my friend Jesse James Sylvia from Martha's Vineyard Island, who finished second in the 2012 World Series of Poker, that aired for 12 hours straight. because they kept it going until it was over. Wow. That's cool. How about this? Also in 1928, on the day the Boston Garden opened, Notre Dame football team lost their first game for the first time in nearly 25 years. Holy shit, what a long streak that is. On this day in 1940, the Green Bay Packers were the first team to travel by plane. First football team, I do believe, to travel by aeroplane. On this day in 1926, Chicago Blackhawks had their first game ever, and they beat the Toronto St. Patrick's 4-1. How about that? And finally, on this day in 1800, John Adams, the second president of the United States of America, moved into the White House, the first president to live in the White House, which current President Barack Obama lives in to this day, 212 years later. Wow. All right. With that said, let's get to, oh boy, today's movie of the day. And it's definitely an interesting one. Olga's House of Shame from 1964, starring Audrey Campbell. A House of Shame from the trilogy of awesomeness. Audrey Campbell, Alice Davis, W.B. Parker, Ella Daphne, a whole bunch of nobodies, basically. But then after relocating to New Jersey, Olga's House of Shame is open for business. With the help of Nick, her malignant brother, and the sweet-faced Elaine, a victim-turned-protege, Olga runs a crime syndicate while gleefully engaging in such extracurricular activities as bondage, torture, and the always popular horse discipline. The most outrageous of the series, Olga's House of Shame also features a surprise announcement for an unmade Olga with a truly mind-boggling title. Now, I wonder if my friend Jessica Dixon, a horse nut that she is, does she know what horse discipline is? Because I have no idea. Probably not. But anyway, there you go. My mother's a horse nut too, and she doesn't know that discipline. My daughter's a horse nut. She doesn't know it either. Better not. Warning, program contains nudity, violence, and bullwhips. Oh, ouch. For maximum effect, view while shackled. How about that? It's a nice little preemptive recommendation. All right, folks, you know, it's time to get to the babe of the day. And also the song of the day. And today's song of the day is an absolute classic. Because we're going all the way back to 1951 to some of the most beautiful sax playing you've ever heard. This song was famous for all those late Saturday night train shows, like case in point, Arnie Woo Woo Ginsburg, WMEX Boston Radio in Massachusetts. WMEX, Wimex, Saturday night, the Arnie Woo Woo Ginsburg, what was it called? The Saturday Night Train Show, or the Night Train Show, Night Train Show. Ironically, the song is from 1951, and it's the original 1951 Jimmy Forrest version of Night Train. This is the song that was used on many DJ's themes back in the day. So, with that said, while we do that, we're going to show off today's babe of the day. And I have to be very careful not to show any nudity. This is Sophie Marceau, because she is stunningly gorgeous. The babe of the day, song of the day, awesome stuff. Here you go. Enjoy. This is the original, folks. James Brown did a phenomenal remake in 1961. You probably also heard this song in the Enchanted by the Sea dance, and this song was played in, remember the Enchantment Under the Sea, or Enchantment by the Sea, or something like that, from Back to the Future, 1985, that's right, Marty. Remember Marty, played by Michael J. Fox. Enchantment Under the Sea, I think it was. Yowza, folks. Kind of see-through. Hopefully I don't get my page banned for that. I love the sweet, innocent look, folks. I do. And that is why Sophie Marceau is one of the hottest chicks. Oh, can't show that one. That's a booby. Ooh, can't show that. That's too see-through. Ooh. Put it this way, folks. If I showed that picture any closer, you'd see the nipples. Nerves. I got a lot of beer to drink. I think that's the look after sex. Oh, can't show that one. Nope, can't show that one. Risky, but we'll show it. Sophie Marceau. Wow. Folks, I'm telling you, French women are gorgeous on average. Oof. Need I say more? And remember, she was in Braveheart with Mel Gibson. She was that hot brunette. Remember her? Love that picture. Just natural beauty, folks. You can't beat that. What do you think, that little Jordan Tyler? You've never heard of her, have you? Because she's well before your time there, kid. Share this one with all your age friends, Jordan. This is... You know what? What the hell? I don't want to go over 30 minutes. But I got to finish this here, beer. And I'm trying to find one more special picture to end it right. Ooh, that's pretty nice. Empty as the brain cells of an average Yankee fan, right, Izzy? Ah, Izzy's a lot smarter than the average, though, I will say that. One more for good measure. There you go. The lovely Sophie Marceau, 46 today. Okay? That's better. You know. Folks, you know what time it... Ooh. I have to. Come on. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, we do. Folks, it's time to make like a fetus and head out, so everybody take care. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink or drive. I spill you drink, or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking or driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. And what's dumber than that is rooting for douchebag cocksuckers like Eli. Oh, I'm as good as Tom Brady. Manning, or men slapping women. Things like that are just plain stupid. I'm out of here, folks. See you all tomorrow. Talk to you later. And don't forget, Peyton and Eli and Archie Manning combined 3 Super Bowl rings. Tom Brady by himself, 3 Super Bowl rings. He's as good as all the Manning family combined. That's it. That's the list. I'm out of here. See you all tomorrow when the Patriots play the Colts. And I make a couple people cry. Catch you all later. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.
No welching on the bet.